Rahnama, excuse me, I always mispronounce it. He is from Risk Management Solutions, and he's going to talk about sales and performance assessment infrastructures. Helmut's journey through the labyrinth. Now, looking at the journey, Helmut has 28 PhDs, 8 engineers, and 2 co-advisors. His face has changed from the beginning when he started, he went to the top, the gate. And through his journey, he took many students with him. And through those processes, everyone tried to really learn from him. And each of them, they had a memory. And memory of each individual is going to be day and night they work is demanding. He transferred his knowledge to us at the same time his habit of working. I mentioned he works on Saturday and Sunday. I work on Saturday and Sunday. I learned from him. So, and there are many students, I wasn't able to find the picture, so I put the people without the picture. But here are their names. There are 28 of them, PhDs. The last one hasn't really finished yet, but it's not finished yet. There are blue, the one I tried to cover. There's a red, there are 2 Persian, which was really my student first, and then went to Stanford and Helmut, and worked with Helmut. So, those are the third generation, and the grandfather is Bertero. Going to Bertero, to Helmut, to me, and then again to Helmut. And I tried to talk about all the people and the work they have done over the last 20 years through the science of demand and transformation from really the excitement of the time to the time we do have a really seismic design and so on. If you look at his research on seismic performance error time, there are 3 versions. Actually, let's go back to previous slide. We always look at the statistic and data. When you send me the 9 names, I found out there are 7 versions and 1 all. So there are 25% of the student version. So I assume he likes it. So the first 3 works with him through the experimental time. And really at that time, they did lots of work. And finally, transformation of these experimental gear to the seismic performance assessment and so on. And if you look at the report number 61, chapter 3, the title of the chapter is saying at that time is models for performance assessment. Yeah, from the beginning it was all about performance assessment. And he wants to really walk us through those time and try to understand how from experiment we can get to the point without the experiment we get the knowledge of what's going on. I don't expect you to read this, but this is the sum of the terminology used in 83. We talked about serviceability, design, criteria, performance, cyclic loading, inelastic deformation, explosion, life safety, and so on. And all these we put the pieces together over the years is providing insight what each of them means. From his experimental time, we come up with cumulative damage, the cyclic loading. And the cyclic loading is really a reflection of the damage from demand, capacity, and so on. And finally, it turned out to this famous cumulative function, which has a C and C, the two C, represent the performance of the building at a component level. Now, the test is coming, it's next. Anytime event is happening, few new PhDs is coming up. So they're trying to work through those processes and try to understand. John Estrus worked after the Mexico earthquake. He tried to understand the strength of ductility consolidation in seismic demand and what was the reason behind some of the collapse we have seen. And these pictures, for each student that I said, is 4 or 5 years of the work. I'm sure many of them, they have many experiences to share. But I tried to really highlight what they went through and the one they got. He came with the concept of the local and really global ductility. And then he really looked at the seismic demand and overstrength. And what he said at the beginning, overstrength when the geomet passes, really absorb more energy for the element which they are not really having sufficient capacity, they're going to really experience damage. And next, look at these three very simple structure models. Through those three sticks models, he tried to understand conceptual. Helmut liked conceptual. If you look through to his qualification design, qualification exam, what he asks you is a deflected shape. He wants to understand you to understand what is the performance of the building and how the building is performed. Through this three sticks model, he looked at the performance running the thousands of the ground motion, understanding of different components of the ground motion, and then try to see what the impact it has. Mobilize the storic energy, cyclic loading, and so on. If you look at all this, one cannot reflect the real structure. If you look at the right one, the real structure, and you look at the below is the final element, very comprehensive type of model, it's very expensive, right? From the beginning, he was really looking from the practical perspective. From some of the highlights, he tried to understand what is the practical aspect and come up with a very simplified solution that can serve the design community. Then it comes to Aladdin to come up and do lots of sensitivity from SDOF, single degree of freedom, to MDOF, and lay out the plan and process, how we can really come up with the design methodology, and those one really went to the FEMA 273, 274, and so on. So we all know about all the publication. And it came another event, Roma Prieto. I was a student, I was chairman, and I worked to Helmut, and I said, here we go again. We have another event. Right now it's a soft soil. And then his voices. And we look at all the ground motion we absorb, and Helmut loves to model everything in the structure system, even the soil. Fully non-linear system, he wants to model the structure, behavior. So we came up with the methodology, we look at the building performance of the building. At the same time, we look at the household amplification, it has to really relate to the period of the building, because every single period is going to perform differently.